you can come wherever you want. We didn't get a lot of time to talk earlier today. So, how many years have you been CPA?
5 years.
5 years?
CPA, a year and a half.
Okay.
But I've been auditing for 5 years.
Auditing for 5 years, okay. Is math your favorite subject?
Clearly I'm not very good at it. Didn't answer the question right. It was not my favorite subject, it was my easiest subject.
Okay. Awesome. So, yeah. Well, we're looking forward to hearing from you.
Thank you.
Yes. All right, awesome.
All right, so as Noel kindly said, I'm Tyler Mason. I'm one of the CPAs of the group. The lovely Jessica is the other CPA. She does the tax side. And I work for Erickson, Brown, and Kloster P.C. This is my wonderful family. There's me with a beard. As you can see, I was a little distracted this morning when I was running through it in my head. I was like, I should trim my beard. Look presentable. And then I didn't put the cap on that. That limits the size. I just was paying attention to, yeah, I'm going to say this, and this. When I look down, there's a lot more than it's supposed to be. So that was a big oopsie, so this hopefully will grow back soon. That's my beautiful little girl in the middle, Addison Marie, and then my wife Melissa, and we are expecting another one actually on August 30th. Yeah, so thank you. We like it here. We moved here about a year and a half ago from Southern California and have been very happy since. A little bit about just me is I graduated from Biola, similar to our friend Joseph over there, and I love to read, write, play disc golf. I don't know if you guys play disc golf. It's kind of fun. Yeah. And it's not that expensive. So that's fun. And I like to just talk to people. So I've been a little busy, as Jessica, CPA is kind of busy right now. But I really do want to get to have more one-on-ones with you guys because that is something I really enjoy doing. And then everybody loves the movies and TV. Specifically, I love the show Psych. I don't know why, but I love to talk about that show. It's just so silly and goofy, and it's a nice break from reality sometimes. And then Lord of the Rings, who doesn't love that? Little hobbits, they run around. He's right here. So
that's right, I'm a star.
Thank you, Sam Wise. So, so a lot of times people ask us, so what do you do? That's a common question, you know, people do stuff. And I frequently would say, well, I'm an auditor. And then people go, oh, I knew it. I didn't like you. So I've been changing that to a financial statement auditor, and that helps a lot because what I do is I go in and I look at people's financial statements. And I help them get it in the proper, I guess, proper form. There's a lot of regulations and a lot of codes that have nothing to do with the Internal Revenue Code that people have to abide by if they're gonna present financial statements to banks or to shareholders of their company. So just a quick breakdown of what an audit is versus a review or a compilation. An audit is a very specific and detailed review of something. So the reason people always think of an audit with the IRS is because the IRS comes and does a detailed review of your taxes. I do a detailed review of your financial statements as a company. So I wouldn't be doing an audit for an individual. I always do audits or reviews or compilations for companies. A review is less detailed. It's more of a, yeah, this looks right, this sounds about right. For a construction client, if they were here in Colorado Springs, I would say, okay, based on the fact the economy has done very well in the last few years, I would expect their revenue to go up and probably their net income. If for some reason it didn't, then we ask more questions and we get better understanding. That way the banks or whoever's relying on those financial statements can know it. And the compilation is the least expensive. It's kind of just like, hey, just give me your numbers, I'll put it together in the right format and I'll give it back to you. Now, I don't want you guys to fall asleep because this is super boring. So if you want to go to the next one. What I am actually passionate about, accounting is okay. I don't think I've met any accountants who go, oh, I love accounting. Last night I was reading. I'm talking about financial statement auditors. Tax people are a whole other animal, they're weird. So I don't know too many people who, on the financial statement auditing side, love to go in and audit people. What we love is the people. So what I get to go do is I get to go meet the CFO And a lot of times CFOs can be scary, or the controller can be scary because they're higher up. But when you get to know them a little bit more, they're people just like us. Mm-hmm. My dad is one of those higher ups for a city. He's a director of finance. And my favorite story is my dad's a nincompoop. Like, he's just goofy, he's silly. He takes his pants off when he gets home, and it's just not okay. He just walks around the house. It's disgusting. So I like to get to know those people, and my passion is learning more about them and making them feel comfortable, because an audit is usually required, or a review is usually required by some other entity, and it's not something that they want to do. Whereas a tax CPA, they can save you money. That's not what I do. I needed to make this whole process much simpler and make you comfortable with me. And then I really like what I do because, no, I don't enjoy reading 200-page documents that they release every single year that are just new and don't necessarily apply to everybody. But the CFO doesn't want to have to read that as well. So the CFO, the controllers, they don't want to have to read every single new accounting pronouncement to know whether or not it applies to them. So they rely on us, and I get to make people's lives easier by doing that. And then something that's really interesting is I actually like stories, because I think numbers tell a story. So if you want to go to the next slide, this is a statement of income accumulated deficit. So those are some fancy words, P&L, profit and loss statement. And I like seeing that these aren't real. I'm not showing you somebody's financial statement. But I really like looking at this and saying, okay, what is this telling me? What story is this telling me? So that's something I get a lot of joy out of. In short, this is a summation of all of the industries that I do audits for with my current firm. The medical profession has a lot of sub aspects, so if you have questions about those, you can certainly come and ask me which ones. But essentially, if they need an audit or a review or compilation, we can do that. But these are just the most common ones in Colorado Springs that I've seen. So, yeah. My favorite of these, I don't know why, but I love cars. I'm not good at them. I can't do an oil change very well. I spill the oil and I get in trouble. But I love automotive dealerships. There's so much more to them than just, hey, they buy and sell cars. Actually, one of the things that I did learn about the automotive dealerships industry is the dealerships most of the time aren't making that much money. They don't make a whole lot of money when they sell those cars. And that made me go into buying a car the next time with a very different perspective. Because whenever you go in and buy a car, you always leave feeling like, I think I got screwed. I feel uncomfortable, and I just signed something. I don't know what it means. But the reality is they don't actually make that much money. But I like the side aspects that they have. So it's very interesting to me. That's my favorite one. And franchises, like I talked about, I think, last week. Those ones are very interesting because they're very unique in what they do. So, next slide. So if you're just looking for who to introduce me to, the training for on MSP said give you guys a call to action. That felt really weird. Really, what I want to do is I want to meet people. I'm very, very new to Colorado Springs. I've only been here a year and a half, and I just started 2.5 months ago trying to meet people and grow my network. I was actually very intentional not to try and do that for a while. I didn't really want to meet people. I just wanted to plug away and complain the whole time and not be in control of my complaining. So now I can actually try at things and put forth my best effort. So really, in general, I'd like to meet more of you. Up until the end of this month, really, I'm going to be uncomfortably busy. But anytime after that, I'd like to meet with a lot of you guys. And then anyone who you guys want to meet or introduce me to would be great. And then overall, just if you're looking for specific people who can actually refer to me or help me get a better understanding of what they're looking for, CFOs, controllers, as Tom said, compliance officers with banks, they're helpful too, commercial loan officers, and franchise brokers. Alex was kind enough to refer me to Chris Johnson, so I'm meeting with him soon. That's very excited about that. And then two specific individuals I've found that I do want to meet, they're in the manufacturing and distribution industry, are Tom Neville and Jason Lockwood. So if you guys know them, I'd love to just have a lunch with them, see if I can help them in any way. And that is it. Thank you guys very much.